morning, dear participants. First of all, I heartily welcome you to this two-week research methodology refreshers course organized by HRDC, Human Resource Development Center, Sri Mata Vaishno University. Today is the commencing day and it will be concluded on 27 March 2017. Now, in the inaugural session, I have given some hint about the program, and Dr. Deepak Jain has already spoken to you about this, so I don't feel that I need to repeat it again. Now, topics have been made in a sequence so that, like A after B, B after C, C after D, D after E, like this, and lastly we land at XYZ. We have tried our level best to set the program this manner. However, during, you know that 2 weeks journey is not very short journey. There may be some changes, some adjustment which may be required and which will not affect your, I mean, course at any point of time, I believe. Since the in charge director HRDC, I had some responsibility and we tried our level best so far to organize the program which will be useful to you. If the program is not useful to you, definitely it is useless to us. And therefore, I heartily welcome you again to this 2 week program. Take it seriously and let us begin with our journey for these 2 weeks. My purpose to take this first session is to just roll the ball, and my different faculty colleagues from different disciplines across the university as well as outside resource persons will be taken care of as much as possible, as much as practical. Now, the first topic, that session, Nature, Importance and Scope of Research. Nature, Importance and Scope of Research. Now, before nature practically, we should know what is research actually. What is the meaning of research? Research is a very common word. In every field nowadays, I am doing research. Whether it is medicine, whether it is social science, whether it is normative science, whether it is abstract science, nanoscience, biological science, research. Now, research, why research? Why at all research? What is research? Research. There are re is prefix and search. Search, research, research, search or in search of knowledge. In search of knowledge, our Honorable Vice Chancellor today itself in the inaugural session, he said that knowledge has to be converted to wisdom. When knowledge is converted to wisdom, then only it becomes useful. Knowledge is of course useful, but knowledge is the third tier. Data, then come information, then comes knowledge, then come wisdom. So ultimately, in any subject, whether it belongs to social science group, or it belongs to basic science group, or other subjects, research means answering to a problem. When in a society, there are hundreds of problems. Hundreds of problems. The problems are to be solved. Now, how the problem can be solved? Problem can be solved by an individual, by his own expertise. Problem can be solved by a group, by group expertise. Problem can be solved by team expertise. Problem can be solved by more than a group or multi-group exercise. Therefore, research means doing something. It's an activity, it's a scientific activity. If you give a problem, a layman, if you give a problem to a layman, he will also try to solve a problem. Say a farmer. Farmer want to know, according to his land holding, how much seed is required, how much manures and fertilizers required, and how long, how much water is required to grow his crops. Now, how he came to know about this? That if this much is my land holding, and out of this land holding I need this much seed, I need this much manures, fertilizers, water, labor, capital. How he knows all these things? So this is, we call it empirical research. It is not by something. It is over the year, thousand years. People are observing it. People are experimenting it. And today people came to know that for this much land holding, for this much crop, having as a result of the farming, so these things are required. So now, that means it's a scientific way. Research is a scientific research and activity. Now research is an activity which is taken care of by group of person who has got certain degree of knowledge, certain degree of education practically. But when a research is taken care of by certain a person having a certain degree of education, certain degree of knowledge, we call it academic research in that manner. But an illiterate man also does research in his own way, but he does not know that it is called research. That is the only difference. He also or she also solves the problems. For example, in any subject, we know about Sir Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton discovered the law of gravitation. It is not invention, it is discovery of law of gravitation. Because law of gravitation already was there. It was unknown to us. The effect of law of gravitation was not known to us much. After that, many inventions have taken place based on this theory of law of gravitation. So therefore, research means some academic exercise, some academic activities, scientific activities, which are taken care of in a scientific manner by following certain rules, certain regulations, certain methods, certain techniques, and then we do research to arrive at a conclusive answer. Dear friends, please understand the conclusive answer. Answer mainly in basic science or normative science, answer does not vary. But in social science, answers sometimes vary because of certain reason. Assumption, what are taken care of, because before searching any research, before starting with research, we need to have certain assumption. We need to start from somewhere. Therefore, certain assumptions are essential there. Therefore, we understand research is an activity, scientific activity, which helps us to find out an answer to a problem. Problem may be economic problem, problem may be environmental problem may be social problem. By and large, human being is called gregarious being, social being. So therefore, their problems are also multitude, and multitudinal problems are to be solved through an activity which is called research. For example, in education sector, government has to make a plan. That next 5-year plan, one 5-year plan, you know, since 1951, 52, our first 5-year plan starts. So every 5 year, government has to make a plan that what will be the resources available, what will be the level of expenditure, and where from this resource will be raised. Tax is one of the important source of raising resources, and therefore government has to make this 5-year plan now from today itself. Now how it will know? It will use its past experience. It will have some assumption that if population growth is every 10 years, there is census, as you know, every 10 years say 5%, there is a growth of population 5%. Therefore, for them you have to arrange for their education, for their employment, for their well-being. Now how government will do? It is the function of the researcher to find out the answer to this problem. Therefore, we understand research means an activity which through intellectual exercise, we find out answer to the problems, and by which a society becomes beneficial. A society becomes, it is useful to the society. So that is the research. Next slide. That we have already covered. Yes. So scope of research, as you understand, that already there is no specific, I cannot say for this subject this is the scope of research. Scope of research, it varies from subject to subject. For subject like physics, for subject like mathematics, the scope is not the same as a subject like law, or as a subject like sociology, or as a subject like anthropology. So scope of each subject research, it depends on the problem in which you are dealing with. So that is the scope of research. To what extent, what will cover, scope means what will be the coverage of the research, your subject. Your subjects, first of all, you will have a problem, and problem has to be studied. After studying in which length, at what length and breadth you will study the problem. So that is the scope of research, that is the boundary of the research, rather I can say. So scope of every subject, it varies from subject to subject. Scope of research in economics and scope of research in management are quite different, not the same. Maybe some similarity, but dissimilarity are many. Therefore, you should also keep this in mind while you will take up any subject, because since this is a general topic I am discussing with you, I am giving an overview of research in general. Therefore, scope of research is an important criterion which you should keep in mind while you are dealing with the research in any subject. Next. Characteristic of research. Now, characteristic of research, here you can see discovery of new ideas, knowledge creation, and examination of new theories, evaluation of new theories. Make it a little closer. Yes, so that I can see. Yes. Evaluation of new theories. Now, discovery of new ideas. Now, in your degree, for example, you are either completed, many of our my friends here who are already a PhD, they are all doctor of philosophy. Many of my friends are here. Many of my students are there who are yet already begun their career as a researcher for obtaining a degree of doctor of philosophy. Now those who have already obtained, they have gone through the rigorous process of research. It is just nothing new to them that what research is. They themselves are the evidence, because they have achieved that excellence, and that's why they have been awarded the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in the particular branch. But does it mean that only obtaining a PhD means a research? PhD is a university degree given in recognition of your achievement in the field of research. Other than this, as I was talking to you, Government of India would like to have next 5-year plan. Next 5-year plan, what will be resource? What will be other, inputs which will require? Now, it may be many universities across the country, many students, many scholars take this as a project. Many scholars can take this as a project, and they can generate their own ideas in best possible manner resources can be raised and resources can be made available to the government, so that government can take care of their problem. So new ideas may come this way. This is one of the way. Many of the researchers who are already achieved certain level, their purpose is not to earn Doctor of Philosophy. They also do research. They take up many projects. You know, there are many, funding agencies across the country. DST is one of the funding agencies. ICSSR is one of the funding agencies. UGC is one of the funding agencies. Now they fund research for what? They fund research for not the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. A particular problem are identified, and the problem are to be solved. A solution to the problem has to be given, and a paper on that, those issues are to be published. Now, while these papers are published in a good journal, it is only in recognition of your research, what you have done. Your purpose was not to earn the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. So many of us sometimes have the conception that research means just to earn the PhD degree is the research. But dear friends, it is not like that. Research is research. Obtaining PhD degree is one of the objective of research, but it is not the sole objective. Research can be in any field, on any problem, when there is a problem, and problem is not solvable by rule of thumb, but scientifically, with the help of logic, then only a research is said to be carried out, and new idea can be discovered, new idea can be coming into the in reality to make advancement of our society towards our economic growth and development. Knowledge creation, already I have told you that. Knowledge, first of all, any data we create. From data, we convert data into information. From information, we convert into knowledge. When knowledge is converted into wisdom, that is the highest tier of research. That level, only few people across the world, they reached to that point, that wisdom. If I say in terms of academic inputs, all the Nobel laureates, mostly, I can say they are at that point of, that level of education, that level of thinking, that level of, their outputs are in that level, which are at the level of wisdom. Now, for example, let me clarify you, difference between data, information, knowledge and wisdom. Data is the raw characteristics of some bit of information in a particular branch. For example, when you are appearing for your master degree qualification, okay. Now what happened? Examiner examine your paper and examiner award you marks. These marks are data. Now when these marks are compiled with, there is a criteria of the university, that if a person in totality score not less than 60%, you will be awarded first division. Okay. Now first division you will be awarded. Now this data, you have studied say 10 subjects. 10 subject marks are added together and then divided by 10, you get the percentage, average percentage of these 10 subjects. And ultimately your result is declared that you are in first class, second class or any other class if they are left over according to your performance. This shows your performance. This becomes information. This becomes information when you say somebody that I got first class. This is an information. Now, this information when put to use with the help of experience, please note it down. When this information means now you achieved certain degree of your maturity, academic maturity, you got first class. Now when this maturity, this mature level of understanding is applied with the help of experience, then knowledge is created. Then that stage we call it knowledge creation. So knowledge is created at that stage, knowledge creation. After that, when further research, for example, you might be knowing Rishi Aurobindo, Swami Vivekananda, okay, Amar Khoyam, another 12th century, 11th century, 12th century, great literalists. So they are the people who reached at the level of wisdom. Not me or XYZ, we are very ordinary people, we are very ordinary person. So we do not have that level. So therefore, ultimate objective of any research to reach the point of zenith, okay, so that point of zenith is called the point of wisdom. Now, evolution of new theories. Next characteristic is evolution. New theories. You know, great philosopher Aristotle says what? Nothing is permanent but change. Every time changing. Today, there is global warming. This is also kind of change of nature. You see, today suddenly we are having rainfall when we normally do not expect. Sometimes we are expecting snowfall when we do not expect. So these sudden things are happening there and these are due to change of course of nature. So nature is changing now. Therefore, nothing is permanent change. Similarly, through evolution process, if you go back 5000 years back, people way of living, people way of, living their earning, their livelihood, quite different than today. Therefore, evolution of new theory is another important aspects of research which normally we try to take into consideration while we do this work. So new things until comes, new things, it's a very broad term. New, when you say something new, new is very broad term. It's a so many, because for example, one myth is there. Many students are there, they are doing research, but they don't want to share their information with others. As if they feel that if I share my information to others, somebody may take my idea and somebody may do something and where my work will be the loser. But it is not that kind of idea. There is nothing, there it is different, your theory, your thesis will be different from others in the same subject. But this is, difference is so, it's a so thin, perception that it is very difficult to distinguish and to say that both things are same, both things are exact or both things are same. Therefore, there is new ideas, new theories may come from different, from the same two persons together, but still they may be different. Still they may be different. So therefore, research means generation of ideas, research means evolution of theories, research means giving and creation of knowledge. Now, purpose of research, as you have seen here, that so many, academic purpose, these are all the academic purpose, as you understand, to push the boundaries of knowledge, to prove some theories are true, to understand principles of existence, utilitarian purpose. So two purposes are there of research basically. Academic purpose, utilitarian purpose. Academic purpose, as you understand, for finding out knowledge, something which is useful to the society through academic process.
That is the academic purpose. Utilitarian purpose, in any society, if you are near there, any society, you can find out that there are theft, there is robberies, there is wars, there is quarrels, there is many other wrong things which take place in a society. To answer this problem and to make the society in better position is called utilitarian purpose, utilitarian purpose of research. So therefore, academic research is the purpose by which your academic achievements are recognized. Utilitarian purpose is there to find out the problem or solve to make in order to find out the best possible happiness to the society, best possible comfort to the society. There is less conflict. For example, in different countries across the world, if you see, there is civil wars are going on. Civil wars are going on why? Because of conflict of interest. So if there is a conflict of interest, then there will be problem. Now these problems are taken care of by utilitarian purpose, utilitarian aspect of research. To understand principle just now, to prove greatest happiness principle and conceptualization of facts. Conceptualization of facts, as you understand, conceptualization. Because ultimately, concept is the foundation of any theory. Without concept, no theory can be built up. So therefore, conceptualization is very, very important in this aspect. Next. Assumption of research. This is the most important part. As I told in the very beginning, that without assumption, we have to begin with anything, we need to assume something. Then thereafter, assumption may be right, assumption may be wrong. But there has to be certain assumption. Without that, we cannot start with. So now, cause-effect relationship, existence of social laws, least biased. These assumptions are very, very important in case of research. Cause-effect relationship. Where there is a cause, there is effect. Each and every action has got opposite and equal reaction. This is the most beautiful example given by Sir Isaac Newton, which is considered to be the law of motion discovered by Sir Isaac Newton. So cause-effect relationship has to be important there. For example, today you are the cause here. We are the effect. Without your presence, my presence is actually immaterial, irrelevant. To whom I'll address? If you are not here, I'll address to the wall, I'll address to the roof, I address to the light, fans, motors. No, you are the cause. I am the effect. Therefore, cause-effect relationship in every field of research is an important area. Anything is like that. For example, I am giving you a small example. One day, one boy, a class 6, 5, 5th or 6th standard boy, was just on the way to school. And he saw a gate roaring is coming on the way. And he saw some people with some stick and other, weapons in their hands. They were running after a dog. They were about to kill the dog. They had to beat the dog. He was very much curious and he went to nearby. People asking, don't come, it will bite you and you will die immediately. So then, seeing that, he understood that this is a problem and this problem needs a solution. Who is this man? You know, Louis Pasteur, who only founded anti-rabies vaccination, what still we use it today. So he is the man. From that day itself, when he was a student of class 6, from that day, his strike is in mind that yes, something I have to do. This is a great problem in a society. That when a mad dog bites somebody, people will die. Okay, so therefore, in this way, what I say that cause-effect relationship. So this was the cause, and ultimately effect came. Vaccination came. He invented that vaccination. Therefore, this is very very important in our life. While we are doing something, we have to find out cause should be relevant, cause should be realistic, cause should be, problem oriented. Next comes your existing social laws. This is another assumption. Social laws. Without law, we are nowhere. In our country, we walk along the left hand side. Americans, they walk along the right hand side. Now why? It is so, it is a law. It is the rule of the world, because it is understanding, you know. I have seen, it is my perception, my feeling that while I walk along the road, I see that how disciplined these motor cars are. One motor car, see, accident takes place. Of course, accident again takes place because of their mistake. Somebody might have committed some mistake. But in general, you see, when there is a traffic or something like that, did you find that any accident or something is going to take place? People are so much patient, they are not impatient. They are trying to give passage to others so that one motor car moves and another motor car moves there. So in most disciplined manner, I see there. So this is called the law of law of the society. That law is there, that law is understandable to everybody. That this is the law, if I break the law, police is standing there. Now you will take care of us, so if you break the law. So this assumption is very very important. And this is, without this assumption, we cannot go ahead. So if we want to solve a problem of traffic problem, we have to understand what are the traffic rules, what are the traffic laws. Then only we can take into consideration and we can solve the traffic problem in our society. Therefore, existing social law in all sphere, every sphere. For example, in a society, we can see there that marriage is an institution. Marriage is an institution. After a certain age, people get married and they become a family in course of time, and the family is the unit of a society. With several family, one society is built up. Now this is also a law of the society. Law fixes up this law is with the society. When somebody does beyond this, then he is deemed to have been breach of rule of the society, and he is accordingly punished. Therefore, without that law, similarly in research also, certain rules are there, certain regulations are there, which you have to follow, and those laws exist. Sometimes some laws are not written law. For example, the whole constitution of UK is unwritten constitution. Can you imagine? In our country, our constitution written, it's a huge, the biggest constitution in the world. And everything is written there. What to do, what not to do. But seems so much differences are there. So much conflicts are there. So you imagine, when a constitution is unwritten, how the result, there is also a problem. How the result of the problem? One, that means certain assumptions are basically there. By virtue of that, they are in a position to solve their problem. Least biased, yes. This is another important point which you should keep in mind while you are doing research. When you are doing research, be impartial. Your biasness, your personal liking, disliking should not be there. If it is there, then the result will not be free from biasness. Free from biasness means it is not going to generate, not going to deliver the result which should be good for the society. Therefore, these are the basic assumptions of research. Next, subject matter of research. Fundamental research, applied research, quasi-social research. Now, it may vary from person to person. It is not very strictly followed there. I have named in this manner. Here, fundamental research means research at basic, very fundamental level, very, very basic level. Applied research means application oriented research. Application of theory into practice is application applied research. Applied research mainly applicable, mainly seen in your industry, in corporate world, mostly. Fundamental research mostly found out in academics, mainly. And quasi-social research, it is a partly applied, partly fundamental. These research are taken care of, these research take place to solve the problem with the help of both of the theory as I have mentioned in this one. Now I am coming to the point that how research is to be done.
Quasi research,
as I told you, quasi means what? Quasi means partly, half. Normally it is called, if you go by grammatical meaning, it is called half. So quasi means is half. So when it is partly fundamental and partly your
applied,
both of them, characteristic of both of them are there in that part, then we call it quasi research. Now I am coming to that part, that in the very beginning, please remember, I have given you the idea that you need to have data. I have already given the example that in your degree level or PG level, your marks are your data. Data means what? Data means a characteristic. It may be a word, it may be a letter, it may be a numerical or number, it may be a way, this kind of characteristic or attributes which are available, this is called data. Now, data, primary data source and secondary data, data are of two kinds, primary data, secondary data. Primary data are those data which are not yet used, this is first-hand data, first-hand data. Somebody used for the first time, this is primary data. Now, secondary data means data which has been used not for the first time, but it has already been used and it can be further used from that particular source, that secondary data. In any research, you need data. Main problem the researcher face, you know, main problem researcher face in obtaining data. Without data, how will you do research? Without data, how you will do your work? It's not possible. In a country, conservative society, they hardly share the data. They hardly want to share. They understand that if I share these things, then I may have some problem, or my family may have some problem. Therefore, I am not going to give you data. For example, during my tenure, myself and Dr. Mohit Kumar Jena, we have done two projects. One project we have done, adoption of banking technology in Jammu region, in Jammu and Kashmir. Another project we have done, process improvement of apple fruit production in Kashmir, in J&K state. Now, it is a fundamental research. From the very basic, very foundation, very primary level, primary stage, we have started a work. We have gone through the villages, after villages in the Kashmir region. The villages, those villages, even those people who belong to that particular place, they also do not visit those villages. We had been to there. We came across many problems, many aberrations about sharing the data. First of all, they were not believing us that we are researchers. They thought we may be somebody, we want to know their apple production, their capacity, how they produce the apple, or how they market the apple, how the pricing they do, the apple, how they make their storing, what they do, whether they have their insurance, whether they make any premium. So many things were important information, they were not in a position to have. Then we had to convince them, we tried to talk to them. We spend some time with them, then gradually they become open and we got our data. So you understand, then only we are in a position to able to, complete this, these two projects. These two projects are over. One project was funded by UGC, University Grant Commission. Another project was funded by ICSSR. So both the projects are over and we have done this project.
Therefore, data is most important part. Without data, you cannot do anything. Now, secondary data. Now, these projects, anybody can take these two projects. They can go further. So, this is the secondary data for them. But for us, we work with the primary data. Next. Yes. Now we are coming to utility of research, social control, social welfare, social prediction, social growth. Already we have covered that. Our again I refer to an individual session because our honorable vice chancellor told that research is a social product. Research is a social product. So this product, ownership of the research result lies with the society. It is not yours, not mine. Okay. We say that it is my research. I have done this. But ultimately society, because society has provided you everything. Society provided you environment. Society provided you all backup. That's why you are in a position to produce this research. Therefore, everywhere, social control, social welfare, social prediction, social growth, these are all essential for our economic growth of society. There are currently there is one economic branch of economics which is called your, that is which take care of environmental, social and economic issues, the application oriented, application part of the economics practically. So therefore in this part also we find there that environment, society and economy, these are three important. Ultimately, our objective is what? Our objective is from our one economic stage to another economic stage. Then only you can develop. Recently, I had been to UAE last year, last 2016. I have visited Dubai as a city. I was so much amazed to see that at least we are lagging behind not less than 70 to 75 years. Inside the airport, train itself is coming and they are taking the passenger from the airport itself and they are taking to them their destination. Now what I learned from that, I understand that those countries, they are economically developed because of their own activities, and the stage where we are today, sometimes, somewhere, they are also in that stage. But through they are in a position to generate their resources and they utilize the resources in the best possible manner. And we could not do because of certain reasons. There is no multiple reasons are there. So economic progress is possible through research only. Economic progress is possible through education only. Economic progress is possible through application of knowledge, what we learn during our day-to-day life, whether it is from university level of education or a school level education, whatever it is. Now in India, about 785 educational institutions are there, universities are there, degree awarding authorities are there. Now these 785, during our independence, when we got in 1947, were about 20, there are only 20 universities across the country. From 20 to 785, taking all together, including IIM, IIT, the private universities, state universities, central universities, NIT, okay, taken together, it is 785. Naturally, we have done something, we have achieved something. We can say that yes, we achieved something. But definitely, again, in comparison to our requirement, it is not that much, it is not matching our requirement. So therefore, these are the social prediction, where we have to predict what will be requirement from tomorrow. As I have taken example in the very beginning, that next 5-year plan, what will be our population growth? What will be our education investment in our, what GDP will be invested in our research? What GDP will be invested in our defense? What GDP will be invested in our infrastructure development and others? Government has to take decision. So for that prediction, research is essential. And social growth, definitely all three are culminated into social growth.
when social growth is achieved, both all of us are in a position to, enjoy the fruits of economically developed countries which they are enjoying today. Next. Difficulty in research. This is another area. So far I have told you what is research, significance of research, research areas, research problems. Now what are the difficulties of research? Already some of them already I have seen that non-ability of good investigator. Good investigator. Actually research as a career, we are all our teachers, we are all our future teachers. We do research with a certain objective that either there will be some career growth, I will be able to do something. But as such, selfless investigator is very, very rare. Like Sir Isaac Newton, like Sir Albert Einstein. Once Sir Albert Einstein was asked that, Sir, you are such a great teacher. You are a great teacher, you are a teacher of universe. You are not teacher of you and me. Now according to you, what is teaching? What is the role of a teacher? He said in answer that it is the supreme art of a teacher to awaken joy in creative expression and knowledge. Once again I repeat it. It is the supreme art of a teacher to awaken joy in creative expression and knowledge. Expression has to be created and knowledge has to be created, and by which a joy will come. You will feel that happy, that yes, I have achieved something out of this. Until unless this kind of feeling comes to your mind, you are not a good teacher. So how does it happen? Because Sir Albert Einstein is an ocean. As all of us know, I am too little to define him. It is enough for me. It strikes my heart as a teacher to understand that what Sir Albert Einstein says. Now it is result of how he said. It is result of his research throughout his life. Throughout he spent his entire life in education, entire research and development. And he is the source of, many, many theories, many, many ideas which help us today to re-arrive at this modern age, what we are today. So therefore, availability of good investigator is one of the important factors which you should keep in mind. Freedom in collecting information. There is no freedom practically. If you ask, because whenever you are approaching with a questionnaire with somebody, he thinks that first of all, he will think that it is a waste of time for him to spend time with you. He will not understand that you are going to do something which is useful to the society, which may be useful to his company even. He knows, but ultimately, from the very beginning, he has got the sense of negativity. Data availability, as I told in the very beginning, that data are not available that way. And inavailability of data means you cannot do your research. Next. Quality of a good research. When a research will be considered to be good, scientific attitude, perseverance, clarity in thinking, subject knowledge, knowledge of techniques, unbiased attitude. Unbiased attitude already I have covered, previously also it was there, it is a kind of repetition you can say. So here you see scientific attitude. Logic is the most important part. Mathematics is the most logical subject. Mathematics is based on logic. Okay, so therefore scientific attitude. You should not be biased with some kind of notion, some kind of superstition, which will help you as an impediment in the field of research. And therefore, scientific attitude is very important. Perseverance. Yes, you are in a laboratory. You are doing some experiment. You are not getting result. You have to have perseverance. And you have to remain patient. You have to find out cause-effect relationship again, that why is not coming, why I am not getting the result, where the problem lies, And for that, it not only is a matter of few minutes, few hours, few days, it may be few years you need to work there. Those Nobel laureate who are today's Nobel laureate, they are not Nobel laureate just because of their work in one night. They spend their whole life. They spend their whole life in the laboratory. And then only they come to such a conclusive research which at the level of wisdom and brings them recognition with prize, Nobel Prize. So therefore, this is very important thinking. Perseverance is very, very important point. Clarity in thinking. Clarity, there should not be any ambiguity. Clearly, your thinking should be think as clear, as transparent as water. There is no room for any ambiguity. Ambiguity means there will be confusion. Confusion means you won't be able to arrive at conclusion. Therefore, clarity thing. Subject knowledge, of course, you know very well, all those who are research scholars here, they are registered in a particular subject, and for that subject knowledge is very important for them. Therefore, more you are knowledgeable in your subject, more you will be stronger in research in a particular subject. So subject knowledge is very important. Knowledge of techniques. Techniques. If you go 50 years back, the way of people is to do research, and the research today they are doing, a lot of difference you can find there. There are so many mathematical, statistical tools, techniques. Without that, today nobody is going to accept your thesis. If you write a statement, a paragraph, and you have to express it with a plus b whole square, a square plus twice a plus b square, if you just simply write that, that represents one full paragraph. So in today's world, you have to be well conversant with the tools and techniques what are available. Mostly econometrical and econometric techniques are very, very important nowadays. Without that, no thesis, no research, particularly in social science. Of course, normative science, mathematical science, there is a separate discipline itself. Their tools and techniques are not exactly the same as the tools and techniques are used in social sciences, management, or in other subjects. But tools and techniques is a must. That you have to know it, you have to learn it. Then unbiased attitude. Already I have covered it, that your biasness should not be there. It should be free from your biasness. Next. So this is the total subject, what I thought that I must share with you. Now if you have any question, you can ask me. I will try to answer your question, and rather I would like to learn from all of you, because many of you are very senior teacher here who were, I expected them, they will be research resource persons, but in spite of that, they are sitting here as a learner. It's a good thing. There is no end of learning. I welcome all of you, and if you have any question or any query, so that I will try to clarify. I will do my level best. Because I will have another session with you in the today is the second half. After this, another our external resource person will be taking one slot after me.
Very good morning to all of you. My name is Devi. I am the resource person for Hindi University.
A little bit higher.
Very good morning to all of you. Yes, sir, I have very basic question regarding your presentation. I think one of the external presentation I found here. Regarding your there are some laws in research.
Yes.
But I think there are some terms like protocols and set of instructions and what we call rules. Are there any basic difference between all three terminologies? Like what we call process, what we call protocols, what we call rules, and what ultimately going to be law?
Thank you, Manoj. Your comment, please. Thank you, Mr. Pranay. You are very correct, practically. Law means I use the law in general term, practically. Not that like a law of contract, or not like a law of the Minimum Wages Act, not the law like the Factories Act 1948. I use a law in a very, in a general sense, actually. So in research, what you say, you are very correct. I endorse what you said, that there is a protocol is there, okay? Rules, of course, rules means, as you know, there is no written rule, if you find that. some rules are unwritten rules are there. Like that, I cannot take, if I take some work from your work, I must acknowledge that through reference. That's why referencing is there. That's why bibliography is there. Okay, so citing is there. So that is the rule, that is the unwritten rule practically. So as such, there is no such kind of law that in true sense or strict sense, but this is the kind of protocol or this kind of rule which you follow while you're doing research. For example, referencing, there is a Harvard style. Okay, people follow that. Harvard style, follow that. This is one of the way of referencing. So there is a particular style is there. That's the style itself is a protocol. So therefore, you are very correct that nothing as in a strict sense, there is no law like that. It's a kind of convention, rather I should, so I can call it better in, it's a kind of convention or custom which are followed in research. Yeah. Ethics, of course, is another important part. Ethics means what? To do right or wrong. That is called ethics, practically. To do, if you go by ethics, ethics teaches us something is right or something is wrong. Now to decide to right or wrong, to take the help of ethics. Ethics is a very important subject. So when I take somebody's work as if it's my work without acknowledging, it is not ethical. It is not at all accepted. Or nobody will accept this. You should accept this one, you should acknowledge. You take his work. There's no problem, there's no harm. There's the ethics never, I mean, restrictive to take that work. But actually, what to do? You have to acknowledge the work. And ethics says something right or something wrong. That thing is, that is the purpose of ethics actually. Any other question?
A very good afternoon to all of you. My name is Mehradi Tirmani, Research Scholar, Center of Jammu. Sir, as per your experience, what is the best way for doing the research?
Very good question. What is the best way to do the research? See, first of all, I'll be covering you certain ideas, certain points in my second slot, evidently. But best way to do research, practically. First of all, you should know why you want to do research. What is the purpose of your research? That is very important. Once you know why you are doing research in the very beginning, I tried to make you understand that research means searching an optimum answer to a problem. Problem may be a variety of different kind of problems. Social problem, economic problem, environmental problem, political problem, what not. So first you understand why I am going to do research. Research means you are going to search a problem. Now how the problem will be solved? Problem is be solved with the help of information. Suppose a person, a pickpocket, has been caught in a bus. A pickpocket is caught in a bus. Now pickpocket, he has been caught. Now how he will be punished? On the basis of the information available that he was a pickpocket. First of all, one evidence, the data, what we say here in your research, practically what we need to have evidence. Evidence that somebody's purse was available with him. This may be one. Somebody might have seen him, that he pickpocketed him. Somebody might have seen him, that he's the only person who has done this, and all other evidences, say photograph of that particular gentleman was also available in his pickpocket. His bank ATM card was also available in that purse. So this is that means information is the basis of taking a decision. Now, to do best research means what? Best research means what? You are going to give the best solution to a problem. Best solution to a problem, how are you going to give? Provided there is a reliability, there is a validity of your data, of your information, then only your result can be good, you can give a good output.
and you follow the scientific process, which I'll cover in the next session, where in details we can discuss about this. Any more question as per this session? Yes.
Good morning, everybody. This is Prince, Senior Research Fellow at BCR University of Science and Technology, Muthal, Haryana. Sir, my question is that the whole thing on this topic, research methodology, is going in a way that research is for the social development. Resource persons, if I say Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, including him, that for the social development. But what I have experienced that the social development is just a conceptual framework. We are thinking that we are research is for the social development, but that is a totally academic terminology. If you are watching advertisements, they are not on the focus that social development. They are just corporatized everything. System is going in the more on the business level. So, is this rightly that research is going instead of social development into the business sense?
My dear friend, first of all, let me tell you that social development means what? How society will develop? For developing the society, you need to have two activities that are important: production and distribution of economic goods and services which can satisfy human wants. For satisfying human wants, you need to produce and distribute. Now, who will produce and distribute? You need some agent. Who are these agents? This corporate is the agent for you. They are doing these two things. Now, your social development, how it is possible if these two functions are not done? Will you get your drinking water? Will you get your food? Will you get your... Okay? And many other things, not possible. So research is social development means what? They are all agents with their combined help, and your research, what inputs you help them. Those corporate, as you say, or those business world, you say, your help, with their help, they do. Then what their purpose? Their purpose is to minimize cost or to maximize revenue. These are the two purposes for which they do business. Okay. Now, why this is required? Again, if I say their objective is to maximize revenue, we'll say I am following capitalistic approach. If you say minimize cost, if I say that I am going to have socialistic approach. This is a different dimension of the problem. I'm not going into details of these two things. But basically, when your research is helpful, you are giving an advertisement. Okay. Now, how the advertisement will do, how it will attract your customer. More customer means more business. More business means more profit. Now, ultimately, who is the owner of this profit, if you say like that? Society, ultimately. So, if you go through that, in this all purpose, ultimately meeting the society. So, therefore, whether it is business, these are the agents who are performing on your behalf. They are the people who are performing on your behalf. And you, as a researcher, they are coming to you, your problem. Applied research, as I told in the very beginning, my application of research, application of your research into a real problem in the society, in the economic, in the industry, they do the applied research. So, therefore, ultimately, the society is benefited. Society means what? Suppose a company today earns 2 crores profit. Tomorrow, a company earns 5 crores profit. Okay, out of 5 crore, company will keep his in 4 crore. 1 crore, you will, at least some employee will get some benefit out of that who are working there. Okay, their salary, their incentive will be, to some extent, will be increasing there. So, in this way or that way, society is ultimately benefited out of the research. That is only my feeling. Okay, so thank you all. And if you will be meeting him again in the second half with another slot I have. and I tried my level best to deliver the, to make the ball roll on. Now for next 2 weeks, all of us will be have exercise and we'll be